Hi, so in this video, we're going to look at the dust solutions that Makita have, talking about the different type of dust extractors, as well as our new cordless system, AWS.
And I will take you through the Makita products that have the AWS system built into the machines themselves.
Hello, welcome back to Makita UK's YouTube channel. My name's Martin Dunn.
My name's Steve.
And in this episode, we're going to concentrate and look at dust solutions by Makita. So we're going to be looking at different types of dust extractors that are available, different solutions for connecting the dust extractors to the machines, and later on in the video, we're going to introduce a new solution for cordless product and dust. If anyone's got any comments or questions, please add them into the comment box below. And then do remember to like, subscribe, and ring the bell. I have on the bench here three different types of dust extraction units. One on my right hand side, as you can see, is a 110 volt machine. The one on the left is a 240 volt machine. And the small one in the middle here is a cordless dust extractor. As you know by now, dust extractors are rated in L, M, and H. Meaning low, medium, and high filtration. On all dust extractors, if they're classified, as you can see, it's shown by either an M or an L sticker. Depending on the size of the dust extractor, most of the power units, the heads on the top that drive the vacuum, are very similar. But for the collection, it's the size of the bin you have on the bottom of the extractor, which will give you an indication to how much dust it will collect. Dust extractors, being L, M and H, as I mentioned, are low, medium and high filtration. They are all fitted with filters inside, a branded filter known as a HEPA filter. But really, it's the motor housing on the head that dictates the filtration of the system. As you can see, most dust extractors will come with a power takeoff on the front, whether it be a 240 or a 110 on the front of this machine here. That will allow you to plug in your power tool and run it in conjunction with the machine. So that means when you pull the trigger on your machine, the dust extractor will start up. When you let go of the trigger, the dust extractor will shut down approximately 10 seconds after you release the trigger. So any residual dust within the pipe can be extracted before it shuts down. Now, with a 240 volt machine, you'll find that most machines will have around about 1700 to 1900 watts of power takeoff and will run most of your power tools. However, when we're looking on the 110 volt side of things, if your machine, the dust extractor machine that is fitted with a 16 amp plug, that can only ever give you up to a maximum of 700-800 watts of power takeoff, depending on the model. However, if you wanted greater power takeoff, most power tools are greater than 800 watts in power, you would need to go up to a 110 volt extractor that comes fitted with a 32 amp plug. So that is something to take into consideration in the future when you're choosing a dust extractor. That nicely leads me on to what I want to talk about next. And this first machine I have, or this cordless machine I have in front of me, which is the DVC-864. As you can see, if I turn it around, it is a twin 18 volt cordless extractor. And again, on the front, we can see it's fitted with a Bluetooth chip. And that nicely introduces our new AWS system, which is dust extraction via Bluetooth dust extractor that can connect up to your power tool.
So I'm now going to take you through the current AWS machines available from Makita UK. We have the DVC-864 twin 18 volt Bluetooth dust extractor, which has the AWS on the machine built in. The built-in device on here will store up to 10 machines at a time, Unfortunately, when you get to the 11th, it will knock off the first one, but it is very simple to pair the devices together. We then have the 18 volt SDS Plus machine, which is the DHR182. We have the DSL800, which is the 18 volt drywall sander. We have the DGA901, which is the twin 18 volt angle grinder. We have the DHS783, again, twin 18 volt circular saw. And then we have the twin 18 volt DHR400 SDS Max rotary hammer. These are all currently compatible with the AWS system, and by holding the button on the front of the machine just there until it flashes green and the green on the device itself, once they're connected, it will go solid blue, and then we know we're ready to go with our wireless dust extraction. If you have already bought into the Makita dust extraction range and have an M class in 110 or in 240, we now have a WUT02 attachment that will be available for you in January. The first one is the 240 volt version, which has a 240 volt plug on, plugs into the front of your 240 volt M-class dust extractor, and will turn it into a wireless dust extraction machine with your Bluetooth tool. Again, easy to pair, hold down the button till the green light flashes, hold down the button on your tool till the green light flashes. Once they've paired, it will go to solid blue and you'll have power takeoff from the trigger of your machine. And then the WUT02 is also available in 110 volt as well. So very much the same as the 240, plugs into the power takeoff on the 110, and then we'll give you AWS function from this machine as well. So these are the machines currently available on the AWS system, and I'm just going to tell you a little bit about the dust extractions that's attached to them or available separately. So the DSL800 has built-in dust extraction which goes through the body of the machine and exit at the back on the dust extraction port. The DHS783 circular saw has built-in dust extraction as well, and you have a dust extraction port on the top. For the angle grinder, there is a dustless guard for cutting concrete which self-constantines on itself, and dust extraction exits at the back of the machine. For any drilling application up to 25 mm diameter, whether it be SDS, combi, standard drill bits, we have this adapter which is available. And then for SDS Plus and Max, we have some hollow drill bits which will extract the dust from source, take it through the tube and extract it out of the dust extraction at the back. So if you'd like to know any more about our AWS system and dust extraction, please look on the Makita UK website under the accessories for more available attachments for the machines currently in the range. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you found it of a benefit on the AWS and our dust extraction systems. Please leave a comment or like in the comment box below. Next time out on our next video, please join us. We'll be talking about the Makita training programs and what we can offer you in terms of training. Other than that, thank you for watching. Like, comment, or ring the bell to keep up to date with our newest videos. Thank you.